whipped cream before I go?
Bye, guys.
I think we're good to go.
Spooky, scary skeletons and shivers down your spine. Shrieking skulls will shock your soul and seal your doom tonight. Spooky, scary skeletons, speak with...
What is up, you guys? It is Maee, and welcome back to my channel. If you guys are new, make sure you guys hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, comment on your video ideas, hit the one next to the subscribe button so you guys get notified whenever I upload a video, which is going to be every day in October, because I am doing the 31 days of Halloween, similar to what is on Freeform, but I am going to be posting Halloween and fall-related videos on my channel. And today is the first official baking video on my channel. If you guys cannot tell by the wonderful ingredients that are sitting up on my counter, we are going to be making what is called a Boo-nilla Milkshake. So, I thought this would be kind of fun, an easy way to kind of do a holiday-related drink, and it has a very few ingredients. So, let's get on into it. So, this recipe, I'm going to be going off the main recipe but cutting it in half because it's just going to be me today, but I will tell you guys all the normal ingredients that are going to be going into it, and I will also have the recipe linked in the description box down below. So let's get on into it. For the milkshake portion of this recipe, you're going to need 4 cups of vanilla bean ice cream. It could probably be whatever vanilla. I think this one's a little bit sweeter. You're going to need 2 tablespoons of vanilla extract. You're going to need about 1.5 cups to 1¾ cups of milk, just depending on the consistency of it. You can get clear cups, however, I got these cute little mason jars that say Boo on them because, you know, they're ghost ones, so I'm going to be putting them into here. So that is what you're going to need for the milkshake part of this. So for the topping, or like the whipped cream, the recipe calls for, I think it's heavy whipping cream, powdered sugar, and milk. However, to save time and money, I will not be doing that. I will just be using what I have in my fridge, which is just gonna be ready whip. So if you guys wanted to try doing the actual heavy cream and all that, if you try it or want to, let me know in the description. But yeah, just the time purpose of this. Yeah, like I was saying, for the time purpose of this video, I'm just going to be using a whipped cream. So let's start making this milkshake. So because it's just going to be me, I'm going to cut this recipe in half. So instead of doing 4 cups of ice cream, I'm just going to be doing 2 cups. So if you have a normal mixed liquid measuring cup, it goes up to 2 cups. So I'm just going to fill that up. If you're pretty good at eyeing it, then you could probably just put it in your blender. My blender is gonna be off to the side, so when I put everything in, I will show you guys. But if you guys ever want to cut recipes in half, you just divide everything by 2, so obviously 2 divided by 4. And then instead of using 2 tablespoons of vanilla extract, I'm just going to be using 1. And then the milk is kind of just whatever, if you want like a thicker milkshake, you would add less milk. If you wanted kind of a thinner milkshake, then you would use more milk, which we'll see what happens when I put it in here. I'm hoping. Also, my blender is a little bit smaller, so that's why I'm not gonna add as much. So yeah, and to make cleanup easier, I am just gonna put everything I have in here and then put it in the mixer. So yeah, then you would get a teaspoon, put that in there. Put that in there. And then I'm going to show you guys my mixer, and I'm gonna put it all in there, and I'm gonna start blending.
Handy dandy blender that I'm going to be using, obviously whatever blender you have. But what is gonna go in here is going to be the vanilla bean ice cream, the vanilla extract, and your milk. So I'm going to do a time lapse of me adding that all in right now. My blender broke. So this is fun. This is great.
For whatever reason, my mixer, or my blender decided that it wasn't gonna work.
So what I'm going to do is I'm just gonna take a spoon. I'm kind of just gonna mix around myself. I don't know how well this is gonna turn out. This is just one of those things where it's trial and error. I'm gonna add some milk to it and I'm kind of just gonna mix it around myself. Obviously I have probably the worst quality blender to exist, but it's turning out so far. It's a little, looks more like a malt milkshake, but because it's not something that's like, so yeah, I'm just gonna do a time lapse of myself trying to fix this, and I will see you guys when I'm done. So after about four or five minutes, I was able to get it to kind of a thinner consistency, which was what I was looking for. So obviously, ideally, if you have a blender, you would use your blender. But if you don't, if you've ever whisked eggs, you kind of just go around and beat it like that, it'll get to a consistency. You might have to add a little bit more milk than normal. But now I'm going to pour everything into my little jar right here. So what I forgot to mention is if you had made the full recipe, so if you had made it with 4 cups instead of 2 cups of ice cream, you would divide it into your 2 containers. I obviously only made enough for one since it's just myself. So I'm going to add the whipped cream now. Got a little shake. And you're just going to add it until it kind of comes up like that. The recipe shows that it has little chocolate crumbles on the outside. I'm just going to add a few chocolate chips to the top of, or chocolate sprinkles to the top of mine. And I'm going to add my straw. And yeah, there we go. I'm not even going to lie to you guys. It's so cute. This actually turned out better, even though we had the little mess up. So I'm going to try it. Oh my god, that's so good. That's really good. This was definitely a success, guys. So, we had our moment where I thought it was going to be a fail. But this video turned out to be super, super, actually really fun. I have missed doing baking videos on my channel. So if you guys like this video, make sure you guys hit the like button. Hit the subscribe button. Comment on future video ideas. Hit the bell next to the subscribe button so you guys can always see when I'm posting videos, which is going to be every day this month at 6:15 Pacific time. For whatever reason, it won't let me upload at 6. I would recommend this. Probably a 10 out of 10. This was really good. That's cute. I love some of the... Okay. Well, I will see you guys in the next video. But yeah, I will see you guys in my next video. If you guys try these, please tag me on Instagram. Or let me know down in the the comment section down below. I would love to see your guys' creations. Hopefully I did a good enough job explaining. But yeah, peace out. I'm gonna get a shot of whipped cream before I go. Bye guys. Scary skeletons and shivers down your spine. Shrieking skulls will shock your soul, seal your doom tonight.